What's good? It's your boy Sneed here, and we got some mutt gameplay weekend league. We're playing like trash. We're 5-3, but as you see, we did something. We got that boy Cunningham. We're gonna try him out. We made him for like 400k, so even if I wanted to sell him, didn't like him, I'm still profiting huge. Gannon's still on the roster as a backup. We have like 2 million coins. We sold Derwin. We made some moves. The Derwin move may not be my brightest, but training is a little cheaper, so we can always make them. But if you haven't subscribed, smash that like button. Let's get to the gameplay. Peace.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. Play fake. Now Cunningham. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
Now a first down throw. Cunningham flush to his right. On the run, he'll let... That's caught inside the 20. And he will score.
And that's Cunningham's first dot. Feel good so far. I like it.
And the Raiders have taken the early lead. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms, because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 26. Now whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First carry for Nick Chubb. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Buying time to his left. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 16 yards, a first down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He's going to look deep now for Landry. Into a double team, and it's intercepted.
That was a heck of a debut. Let's see if we can get another one added to this. We will be right back, maybe.
A few moments later.
And we already just got done blowing this guy out in Randall Cunningham's debut. This is the second game with Randall Cunningham, and I got a feeling I'm going to be splicing these two games together because he's probably just going to quit again. But if you haven't subscribed, smash that like button, and we can try this again. Let's see what he does. Peace.
Tyler Bass about ready to get us going. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's Cunningham. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
4 yards on the pickup.
Second and 6. They'll come up second and 6 now from the 24. Now Cunningham. That's caught. It's Jerry Rice. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 23 yards the pickup there.
A nice catch there by Jerry Rice. And when you look at the yardage he compiled in his NFL career, it seems staggering at 22,985 yards. But let's put a little context with it.
Yeah, we ran the numbers earlier. Larry Fitzgerald, who was contemplating retirement this past offseason, would need 7 more 1,000-yard seasons to break Jerry Rice's record.
That's context.
Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right. And this is taken in at the 5. And finally out of bounds, just a few yards short of the goal line at the 3.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focused, because if they don't, more plays like that will result.
And Cunningham with his first rushing touchdown on the squad. He throws dots, he runs it in. What more can you ask for? The first two games, it's against a guy who's, let's be honest here, probably not at the skill level I would like to try something out this with, but hey, a W is a W. Let's go.
Now Janikowski following the score, he'll boot this one away. Taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
For conventional football, football 101 tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. A first carry now for Nick Chubb. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 7 yards there and a first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Flushed out right. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
I think that interception happened for 2 reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Gotta know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Off play action. It's Cunningham. Open man. That's Noah Fant, the tight end. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. Gun here. It's Cunningham escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Flush to his right. He'll run it, and that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. Call it 7 yards on the carry, so a pretty good game, but still left with a tough 3rd and 8. Cunningham, eluding the pressure right. He's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
It's about teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
You know, he hated taking the loss there on 3rd down. 10-0 to score after one on EA Sports. Out to kick is Janikowski. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Browns drive about to get started. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up 1st and 10. Big hole to the 30. Finally taken down at the 32-yard line. 1st down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards. The CD a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast and in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
The last run got 3, now here's 2nd and 7. From the gun, Mayfield, flushed out right. Here, and that's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
They talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up the 1st down.
They'll get this out wide to Metcalf. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Give him 30 yards there. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
Mayfield. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Nick Chubb, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up 2nd down. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. And he's going to keep it here. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. Now Mayfield being chased out left. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
It's not like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
On 3rd down, Mayfield flush to his right.
The Raider defense strong on that one in coverage, and now it's fourth.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. To throw, Mayfield dancing to his left. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Browns unable to move the chains on fourth down. And the Raider D, they get the football back. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Randy Moss, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down. They'll run with Sanders. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And nothing but daylight ahead. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Randy Moss, 88 yards. And the Raiders add six to their lead.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow because they've had a tough time through the first two quarters. They really were determined to get a stop there. Unable to do so, that makes their comeback hopes that much more difficult.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. This will make it into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Cleveland offense ready to go. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it...
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Rob Woodson. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Battle on the clock, second quarter. Why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing...
This is intercepted. Deion Sanders, the Hall of Famer with a pick. And he's got his guys a shot for 8 points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb, and that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Final play of the half, Mayfield. They'll roll him out right. And Mayfield again with the interception, his third. Picked off by Dominique Rogers-Cromartie. Accelerating and off he goes.
They ain't ready for us.
And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score.
Partner, what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. Fielded in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Browns drive about to get started. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help them a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Third quarter action. Appreciate you joining us from Cleveland, Ohio. Second and 10. Mayfield now. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick, and it's third down. Mayfield to throw it. Rolling to his left. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Now a loose football. The ball comes out. Skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the six-time Pro Bowl